Hello and welcome to By the Numbers. I'm FMTET. I hope you're doing all right. In this episode, we've got a bit of hope. Some good things have happened compared to where we were last time. Not intentionally. So I did say I was going to the end of the last video, where my camera froze, by the way, and I didn't realise, which is why there's no camera on now. But I did say at the end of the last video, I was going to go through the kind of KPIs, maybe use some of the kind of Fantastic Four KPIs that Simon Keen has used on Dictate the Game, based around sort of Big Sam Bolton side. So that's what I was getting ready to do, because basically I imagine by this point would have lost a lot more matches as well in between the last video and this one. But actually, it's been a bit different. So we're going to play Porter down in this video, who are down in 12th. And you can see we're no longer in the relegation zone. Something's happened. There's some different points total there. So the last match you've seen was us losing 3-0 at a full house to Crusaders. We then played against Coleraine and we won 1-0. Set piece goal. Kept them kind of out of our area for the most time. They got more shots than we did, but they were from distance for the most part. And then I realised that we'd used a different tactic. So right at the end of the video as well, from the last video, I showed you all this tactic as a potential backup for shutting down the game, or shutting down games. And I didn't take it off this, I forgot. Because it's a diamond, I just saw the diamond carried on. And when I went to team selection, I saw the diamond carried on. So we got that 1-0 win using this, which is mainly just for kind of stopping stuff. Keeps us more kind of, we regroup rather than counter press. We don't press as urgently. We keep our shape. We don't sort of play as fast. We play much slower, so lower tempo. We slow down the pace with our kind of distribution from our keeper and so on. We're not passing into space anymore. We're more disciplined. And we won 1-0. So at the start of the next match against Glenavon myself, but we lost this one 1-0, but for the first 15 minutes I played it on full match, which again, something Simon recommends from the podcast. We recorded the podcast recently, which is why I keep mentioning it. And for the first 15 minutes, so it became clear this tactic was really good at limiting good opportunities for the opposition. So it basically looks really good at bringing down the XG against, reduces their chances, means the chances they do have from distance quite often or from set pieces, really kind of locks that down a little bit better. But we were still pushing forward, we were still getting balls forward, we still had a few nice little moves, and we lost this one 1-0. But it was clear from that initial kind of 15 minutes and the rest of the highlights that the issue's not, or at least in that game, was going forwards. It was, we had players in the right positions, in the right kind of things, but they weren't actually linking up particularly well. It was a final ball that was kind of missing. So we went to play against Ballymena, which we won 6-3. We made a few changes. So Devlin came back in to partner Bonis with Cockcroft behind them, because they've got all really good links. So they know how each other sort of move and play. And Devlin also had really bad training rating recently. Bonis as well, and I shouted at them both, I criticised them both. And 6-3 makes it look like Ballymena played alright, but actually we were much better than all the way through. And Devlin got his hat trick. And this goal is something special. Like, I enjoyed this one. And one of their goals was like a deflection as well, so it wasn't really as bad. But long ball forward, Devlin, rocket, in it goes. So 6-3, and again, that's these three are using the defensive matches, and we've got 6 points, which is what, 6 points again? Can't be right. Getting something wrong there. My maths is wrong, but basically, in those three matches, we managed to get almost as many points as we had previously. Just 2 points short, basically, compared to all of this. So we're going to try and play Porter down using the exact same tactic, really. We've got to make a few changes. We're going to have to bring McGreevy in for Keevan, because he is off injured. And that's about it. We're going to start with Devlin and Bonis and Cockcroft up front. and bring Burns back in for Evans, and get Evans back on the bench instead of Mitchell, and that should do it. See how we get on. Yes, I'm not going to bore you with the stats of the individual players just yet, because it seems like this tactic is doing the business. Now, they are a team that's below us and in poor form, so we should really kind of attack them, but it's not really worked out well for us in the other patches. There we go. Motivated at least four of them. See. In our funky away kit. And I think if we attack, there's a good chance, because they're a reasonable side. The reason why they're in the relegation zone probably isn't anything to do with the quality of their squad. It's just a little bit lucky. They've always been quite a strong squad in the game. So I think if we attack them, we'll get punished. Or more likely to get punished, considering we've not got a huge cutting edge. It's not like we're going to be able to do kind of 6-3-1 if we're attacking. We've not managed that so far. So I think if we keep it tight defensively and work from there, that's much better. A draw works for us. See, Devlin almost got in there. But yeah, a draw works for us much better than it does for them. It keeps us above them, keeps the gap, keeps the points ticking over. Draws were okay for us this season. Go on, Dan. In it goes, Bonis. Good idea, though. We're getting more chances like that. See how they do. We're also scoring more from sort of set pieces. We've got quite a few set piece goals so far, which is kind of what we want, really. Maximise that. Robinson's there. Why? Honestly. I've seen other people mention that, though, that kind of move where they turn around and then boot it back into the crowd. I think that's not a full representation of what's going on. That's just the graphics. Oh, Burns. From set piece. There we go. So we're ahead now. We're already playing defensively, but we've gone ahead. Nice. Happy with that. We're not beating them on possession or anything like that, but we're not interested in beating them on possession. I brought Young back into the squad as well. Not just because my coach doesn't like him doesn't mean he's not actually any good. Devlin almost getting there. Devlin's looked a lot livelier since he's had that breakout of the team. Cockcroft's in swinger. Yeah, out it goes. He's too slow to get to that. He's quite tired, to be fair. And I'm going to have to sub him this match, I think. Long ball. Not quite worked out for us this time, but Dunn's picked that one up. Got options. Devlin's in there, getting into Devlin. Bonis. Bonis snuck in. So this is if we could win this one, even 1-0, that's huge. The draw also works for us, but the win would be massive at this stage. On Bonis, get around him. That was all over the shot, but got something in. We've got new players coming in at the end of the month. Got a lot of games this month. Bonis tried to whip that one in. Got some new players coming in, which means we've got more options up front. Might be stronger in the fullback positions. That was a bit wild, that one. It's gone off the corner flag for throwing. So there we go, we're edging ahead as well, so defensively this is, well, it's a defensive tactic. It doesn't mean we're just not getting forward. Let's bring a Cockcroft now for Downey. I don't want to injure Cockcroft or something like that when we don't need to. I think we might lose a little bit of our cutting edge, but at least we've got the goal already. I did do a little bit of a kind of dig around the lower leagues to see if there's anyone who might want to come. We've only got £3 to spend, but no. Nah. We did also get our youth intake preview, which suggests we're going to get some good wingers and fullbacks, maybe even a good defender, but that's about it. No strikers, No central midfielders, no defensive midfielders. Almost. I do feel like Bonis and Devlin are gradually coming to the end of their time with us, because that's an area where we can improve vastly. Still getting goals, obviously, but that's the... You're only as good as a kind of the quality of your target man in a formation like this, really. That's one of the limiting factors. Devlin, there he goes. So these defensive wingers are also told to kind of, well, generally hold position and cross from deep. So Robinson did get more forward than I'd probably wanted him to, but he's not getting all the way to the byline, so that's still a deep cross, technically. There's Devlin. Sneaks in. 4 goals in 2 games since coming back. I think now with 2 goals ahead, we should be all right, because at least we're already on a defensive formation. It's in previous games where we kind of naively kept that really attacking diamond, gone 2 goals up, and they pushed, and then we kind of collapsed. It's, we've still got that structure. The regrouping really helps. It's an option. If you're struggling and you're getting caught in the break or getting caught out, take off your gegenpress, put regroup on. Penalty, because Bonis fell over. Soft penalty. He's taken it. Coulter, of course. Yeah, let the central defender take it. Idiots. Idiots. Whoever let that happen. Probably me. Let's make another sub. Bring on McLaughlin for Bonis. And Evans for Coulter, because he's on a yellow card. I'm tired. Keep that defence relatively tight. Hopefully. Get the win. McLaughlin to Devlin. McLaughlin scored in the last match as well from a set piece. Oh, they've gone over the top. Blocked. Nicely done. I think from looking at the match stats and looking at the score, you wouldn't be able to tell that this is our more defensive tactic. Evans going long. No one there. Ooh, almost. Almost in. A bit weird. He's through. It's loud because he was offside. It's the only reason why he was through. Don't need to see that offside again. He was definitely offside. Trust me. I'm getting tired. Actually, this formation is less. Why has the game just kind of stopped? No. Downey puts it in. Yeah, it's a less intense actual formation. There's less pressing, less dribbling and running with it, more letting the ball do the work. Even less running into space. That kind of Graham Taylor approach. The long ball's being played to the person rather than into space. We almost went over McCallion then. Like Port Down haven't been without threat, but we've generally, I think, nullified them quite nicely. There we go. A huge win for us against relegation candidates Port Down. Puts on 17 points. It's a bit different from before, isn't it? Whoops. Oh, that works out all right. I don't know why. I'm far from pleased. Fired up and motivated, even though we've just beaten relegation candidates 2-0. I don't understand Football Manager sometimes. I really don't. Managerless Port Down. Okay. We took advantage of them. That's fine. So this is where we are. Ninth, 17 points, 5 points clear of even the relegation playoff place, and 8 points clear of the actual relegation spot itself. If we can keep on grabbing points like this, we should be okay. We can put a bit of distance between us and everyone else. I've got the LAN match. I might come back and record the LAN match just to see how it goes, and then we've got these two we should play afterwards, and then maybe come back somewhere around here. Will I play the LAN match? Actually, no, because we're going to get beaten. Let's not pretend. I come back for maybe Dungannon or something, so that's probably a bit more relevant considering where they are. Same with Balin and Malarda as well, really. But yeah, thanks very much for watching, and I will see you all later.